My name is Naskademini. I'm a Montreal-based photographer and artist. I grew up in Montreal, born to Caribbean parents. My father was a DJ and entrepreneur, so I grew up with a lot of music in my life. I think my fascination with photography started when I was a kid looking at my father's vinyl collection and seeing all of the artwork. And the artwork on these records were always amazing. I think even as a kid, I used to try to redraw them or retrace them. And I think that's when I became fascinated with art. My background is in web design. When clients wanted sites designed, they also wanted photos to go on their website. So I kind of wanted to be a one-stop shop for everyone coming for business. I would say right now, I specialize in portrait photography. My style is very minimalistic, black, dark backgrounds, so free of distraction, and just working with a subject in an intimate fashion. Today in the studio, I'm going to shoot my twin brother, Marcus. It's always amazing to have someone who looks just like you in front of the camera, because it's kind of like taking a selfie, but I get to like practice on myself. So it's almost like a self-portrait whenever I shoot my brother. Usually I work with a model, I would do some research on the person or subject that I'm shooting to kind of get to know what they're about, what do they do, what they're into. So when they come in, there's a certain level of icebreaking already done beforehand that I can kind of sit them down and make them feel comfortable in front of the camera. My setup's usually done beforehand, so my backdrops are set up, my lights are already in place, and I typically try to go with one style that I know would get the best results. Planning is always essential. So you go in with the plan in mind of what you want to do, but then eventually you kind of improvise while you're on the scene, while you're on the spot. If somebody comes in and you're not feeling up to it, or they're feeling a bit sick or shy or whatnot, you then have to be quick on your feet. Sometimes subjects give you a tell in your face and you're like, that's the truth that I want. And that split second, if you have the opportunity to capture it, it's kind of what you do. In the studio, I shoot mostly digital medium format. I use a Pentax 645Z. I do a lot of my portraits with a macro lens. The macro lens gives me the detail and sharpness that I get excited for. When I'm doing street photography or in the streets, I would walk with my Leica, the M240 with a 35mm 1.4. It's a rangefinder, so it takes a lot of practice to get the shot, but it brings back the joy of photography in me, shooting with a rangefinder. I think a lot of people get too caught up in social media presence and followings and likes, and I feel like it's just about creating. I give props to anyone who just gets up in the morning and creates, because creators, in my opinion, run the world. I don't think we have a role per se, I just think we should always just do what we love and live it out to the fullest. My best photo of 2017 that really moved me, that I was really happy with, was of an elderly woman by the name of Thelma. She's 85 years old. We created a makeshift studio in a community center. She came in with a certain level of wit and slyness, and I captured her personality to perfection. The way she kind of gazed away from the camera, the lighting was perfect, the details were perfect. So I would say that that's my favorite portrait of 2017. My mentor once told me, everyone has a pen, but not everyone is an author. So I commend anyone who has a passion of creating and living out their calling. If you're not passionate about photography, eventually you might just put the camera down. Those who are passionate are going to keep shooting and keep producing amazing work for the world to see. So I never get worried about the influx of people. I actually welcome more photographers to push the boundaries and also inspire me and others to want to create more. Once you see a shot of someone who just started photography that impresses you, it kind of gives you the battery in your back to say, you know what, I want to go out and create some more today.